heck is love? In this video, we will discuss love as not an emotion, but as an idea or decision. It is a practice or a commitment to the betterment of yourself and all others around you. The philosophy of love requires careful consideration and self-awareness, or one can become unbalanced, causing an unhealthy situation toward oneself and others. I would like to consider this the philosophy of love that all poets, prophets, philosophers, and peacemakers talk about, from Gandhi to Buddha to Jesus. As stated before, one must learn to cultivate their empathy. However, one must learn not to get overwhelmed with the suffering of the world, or let themselves get walked all over and taken advantage of. People walking the path of love will be constantly working to get themselves into a healthy balance of love for others and themselves. Here we have a Chinese element diagram I designed a few years ago. I like to use these because they are great assessors of extremes and balances when used right or incorrectly. The points of the star are the traits you must maintain to be in balance, and the outlying areas are what happens when you take a trait to an extreme or deficiency. We will look at each of the traits we need to focus on one by one. Protective. Being protective involves making all of your decisions with the safety and security of the person you love in mind. This could involve not only their personal safety, but their emotions as well. It is a decision to work for what's best for someone. However, everything can be out of balance. Smothering. While trying to be loving, many will try to protect the one they love, almost to the point of imprisonment. They may try to shelter the person from harm to the extent that they are ignorant of problems or how to survive without the other person. This is one side of codependency. People need to be given freedom to trip up and learn from their own mistakes and blunders. Otherwise, they will keep repeating the same problems. Also, being overprotective may drive the person they love away or build a mutual resentment. Do not give protection where it is not wanted, needed, or helpful. Enabling. This is the other side of codependency. When someone has a habit or an addiction, and someone allows them to continue to do it without limits, that person will begin to take their enabler for granted, and the problem will continue to get worse until a destructive breaking point to the self or another. Spousal abuse and domestic violence, as well as drug abuse, many times have an enabler adding to the problem. The abused one has to stand up or leave, but many times they will take the abuse and justify the problem away while the problem gets steadily worse. It takes real strength and real love to stand up and protect both you and them from themselves. Unbiased. This is a very difficult one. It requires a person to step back and look at the situation without emotion and bias to determine the most logical solution to help the person they love. Most problems involving loved ones are emotionally charged, and as we have seen before, emotions tend to make the path fuzzy and confused. Many say that without emotions, we would be robots. However, in some situations, especially ones with a possible solution, refraining from the reveling in emotion can help prevent further disaster. Allowing oneself to have emotions about the situation is fine, but when a decision has to be made, emotions can cause disaster when left unchecked. Weather vane. This is where the situation or the loved one can sway your emotions at every turn. Some people are particularly good at swaying others' emotions and being aware of the types that you are susceptible to, and either avoiding them or learn to diffuse or resist their manipulation is very important. Manipulation, the opposite end of the spectrum. These are people I often refer to as having inverse empathy. These people are so cynical that they see others for how they can use them and not for how they can help them. Inverse empathy is useful in pack animals, like wolves. It is how alpha males in both wolves and dogs will establish dominance. However, in the human realm, inverse empathy is usually quite dangerous, in such cases as Hitler, Jim Jones, and a used car salesman. People who discover inverse empathy early on rarely develop empathy for others and don't even realize that they are manipulating others. People doing things for them is just expected and part of their reality, and they will surround themselves with people acting as parasites toward them. It takes serious self-awareness to cease the use of inverse empathy. Self-esteem. This is a very important aspect of love. Love for yourself. If you are not caring for yourself, how can you afford to help others? When Mother Teresa first started her mission work, food ration. Later that day, she collapsed because she had no energy because she was so malnourished. She learned from this that to take care of others, one must first take care of themselves. After that, they can help others. This is true both physically and emotionally. Martyr. This is exactly what happens when a person does not have self-esteem. They don't feel like they deserve good things or the respect of others without groveling, so they will bend over backwards and usually wear themselves out trying to please everyone. It actually requires a lot of self-awareness and resistance to stop yourself from using someone like this as a doormat, because they make it so easy to do so. Instead, doing things to lift them up and politely refusing help when appropriate might help that person realize that they are worth your time without having to resort to slavery to earn it. Abuse. This is what happens when self-love is taken to the opposite extreme and will use destructive and damaging methods to keep the person or people they want around.